Hello everyone, good morning. Hope you guys doing good. So guys, today I'm going to show you how the activity monitor helps to check the database performance. So this is my management studio I have already connected, and here you can see the right the top corner activity monitor icon. You can click on that. Once you click on that, you will see the activity monitor is open. Now we have around 5 parameters which need to check from the activity monitor. So first one is the process. Once you click on a process, you will get the first session ID, then the logins, and the here you can see the database name, okay, and the command which is running currently on which database, that you can also get it here. And the here you can get the, you know, with the wait time, wait type, and the important thing is the blocked by. So if any session is blocking any queries, you can get the session ID here in this column, the blocked by, okay. And the host name also you can get it from the here, and the few other parameters also you can get it, but it is very helpful to you know, check the blocked by and the head blockers, okay. So any blocking running on that particular instance, you can get the particular session ID and you can kill on that. So how to kill that? So let's assume if this session is consuming the blocking, either it's a as of now it's a select command, select is never creating the blocking, but if any the DML operation is running on and which creating the blocking session, so you can get it the blocked query here, blocked session ID. Go to that particular query and right click and kill the process. If you want to see the details, which what is the query running, once you click on details, there is another window will be open. Here you can see the query, okay. So you can take this query and you can share with the application team, this query is creating the blocking and this is the session ID. So once you got the approval, you can you know, proceed with the kill the session for the blocking. So in the process tab, you can get these many facilities to check through the activity monitor. Although we have a nowadays command, but this is the inbuilt tools from the Microsoft, which can help to check the database health, okay. The second one is the resource weight. Once you click on a resource weight, so in the first column, if you see the weight category, so these are the weight category. You need to understand the each weight category here individually, and here the wait time, recent wait time, these are the parameters which you need to understand while doing the performance tuning, okay, performance check. So which wait type, what is the buffer IO, what is the lock, okay. So these are the parameters you need to understand, and then you can pull the details from here, the under the resource wait type, and you it will help to do the performance analysis, okay. So data file IO, which is also helpful, it will give you database files input output details, okay, and from based on that you can see the how the read write operation going on particular database file, so which can help you to do the analysis for the, you know, the drive level. The recent expensive query, which is also very helpful, whatever the recent expensive query is running in terms of high CPU, the physical reads, logical reads, so these are the parameters you can do the analysis in terms of each and every individuals. So if any expensive query which is causing the high CPU, high logical reads, physical reads, you can share with the application team, and this query need to any extra index or whatever the need to tune the query, you can discuss with the application team, you can share the query. These are the expensive query which is causing the high resource, okay. So this tab is very helpful. And the last one is the active expensive queries. So this is also something very helpful in terms of every parameters you will get if any query is active which is consuming high CPU, high database read write and operation. So here in this tab you can get the same, like, you know, the elapsed time. As you can see, the some queries elapsed time is quite high, that definitely that query having the some issue, either that query needs a particular index or whatever need to tune the query, and maybe the transaction need to do the small chunk in terms of while doing the transaction from the application side that need to distribute actually. So this tab is also very helpful. If any active query is consuming high, so you can share the query to the application team. If you are getting the high CPU alerts very frequently, continuously, if you are getting the high CPU alert, definitely you need to check on that and you need to discuss with that. So today motive is how we can utilize this tool to do the performance health analysis for the particular SQL instance. This tool is very popular and very useful. You can get the particular beautiful graph here also, and easily you can access, as I say, directly you can go and get the query details and everything. If you want to see the details, it will immediately send the queries and all. If you want to kill the also, you can directly go and kill the process. So this tool is quite user friendly to do the performance analysis, although we are using the command, but this is the, you know, inbuilt tool which is placed in a SQL Server engine itself. Okay, so hope you got the points how to utilize the activity monitor. In a next session I will come with another SQL tool which can help to do the performance analysis. Okay, till then, bye bye, thank you. And whoever new on my channel, please like to subscribe. I have created already the SQL Server playlist here. If you go my channel, if you click on a playlist, there are around I think more than 100 videos SQL Server DBA, okay, so which all will help you to improve the, you know, day-to-day activity. Take care guys, we'll meet you soon. Till then, bye bye, thank you.